Hello everyone and welcome back to Around the World in 80 Planes, Next Plane 11. I have discovered the problem that I was having in the previous couple of flights, I think, and that is that I had experimental flight model active and it messed up the aerodynamics of the past two, the AN-225 and the FA-18, especially when they were trying to land at low speeds, at low thrust. They handled really, really, really poorly, like space shuttle or worse, kind of poorly. So that's why I think I was having trouble landing, because I was just not used to the feel of it like that. So I had that on because I had flown the T-38 from Houston to Cape Canaveral ahead of the SpaceX DM-2 launch during a live stream for that launch. So that T-38 requested that I use the experimental flight model. I accidentally left it on because I thought it would do no harm, but it did harm. So anyway, this is the Vertavia B-47. And it looks like this. It is a payware plane. It is a nice plane. I originally meant to fly the AN-24 by Parnic Sim. That's actually a freeware plane, but really high quality. In fact, possibly higher quality than this plane. No offense. It's just really a really good cockpit for that AN-24. But I wasn't able to drop the flaps on that plane. I don't know, maybe the AN-24 doesn't have flaps, but I think it ought to. But other than that, also whenever I flew that plane, then the next plane I flew, it wouldn't read the controls at all. So there was something buggy about that AN-24. So I'll leave that be. And I'm flying this instead, but this is not without its issues. This has an issue. For instance, I have the center of gravity moved all the way back, as far back as I could. If I move it forward to where it is zero, and you know where it is naturally, it noses into the ground. It can't get off the ground, and it basically, yeah, so things are not good. To get it off the ground, I had to move it further back. And basically, once I went past 30 inches, I decided to just shove it to the back, and that seems to work fine. So here we are. That might cause problems as we deplete fuel, though, but that seemed to work out. I was able to take off and land during the test flight. For all these things, I do want to test fly them before I fly them during the Around the World in 80 Planes thing, obviously. And so, I don't know why only when they're planes that I haven't flown before. That's why I didn't do the FA-18 first. Anyway, so here we go. Throttle up. And we'll take it from outside. It's very nice on the outside. And we're gonna start, continue with the Apollo 13 audio already in progress. Okay, here we go.
Aquarius Houston, go ahead.
We have gathered the material. And I could put Jack on the headset and he can drop your instructions for your AAV for can I copy the camera so far and make the detail.
Well, why don't you put him on the headset, Jim, and I'll reach out to you.
Okay, we are off at good speed, so hopefully no problems. They're talking about the procedure to adapt the command module CO2 units to the lunar module CO2 system.
And we'll do this on one canister and then let you go ahead and repeat it on the second. So take one of the LCGs and cut off the outer bag by cutting...
Oh, I didn't mention actually, because I had so many other things to say. We're flying from King Salmon in Alaska to Anchorage in Alaska.
We'll do the next step.
The shiny textures are looking a whole lot more like a whale with the clouds reflecting on the bottom of it. It's looking good. It's an interesting plane. It's sort of got a fighter cockpit, but it's a bomber. Okay. An intercontinental bomber.
Now then, we want you to take the tape and cut out two pieces about 3 feet long or a good arm's length. And what we want you to do with them is to make two belts around the sides of the canister. One belt near the top and one belt near the bottom with the sticky side out. Wrap it around, sticky side out as tight as possible. It'll probably take both of you to get it nice and snug. Over.
Okay, now we've got to make a belt around the top here.
I decided not to use the track IR this time since it's mostly outside. I'm probably carrying too much fuel for a 250 nautical mile flight. This will be a shortish flight. Cloud seams.
You see, Jack, what we're going to do is slip the bag over this whole assembly, and the cue card will serve is across the top of the arch, and anchor it down to the sticky strips along each side.
Okay, yeah, I got the idea. Okay, let me just repeat it here. Take a cue card, form an arch over the top.
Unfortunately, I couldn't get very good photo scenery for Alaska. There is some photo scenery near Anchorage, but it's sort of patchy, not very well integrated. The colors are all off, and so, and it's inconsistent. So, really wish Alaska had better quality photo scenery, since it is obviously very beautiful. But since it's a cloudy day anyway, we do have real-world weather on, so the clouds are here, so it's not too bad. We're not missing too much though, it's just the stock scenery mostly down there. OBS, which is recording this for me, is saying encoding overloaded, so I think the clouds give it a lot of trouble. So, oh, the clouds just briefly cleared there. Maybe I'll use my little utility, it's not even on, to try and limit how intense the clouds are, so that the recording doesn't have too low a frame rate.
Ooh. To stick in that hole. We recommend that you either
oh, there's the moon.
Or cut off a piece of sock and stuff it in there, or you
cut off a piece of sock. Just stuff something in there. See, oh, that's a shinier angle.
Depends what you mean by size, over the open ends of the arch.
Right, the open ends of the arch.
Okay.
Okay, Joe, we've got that done.
Okay, now press the bag against the sticky belts that we put on the sides of the canister. If there's any excess material, just kind of pleat it so that it makes a fairly tight seal. And then take another 3-foot strip of sticky tape and wrap it around the outside of the bag opposite the bottom sticky belt to make a nice tight seal.
Many interesting things about this. It's interesting to know, for instance, the outer engines tilted up, I suppose, in a way helping it off the ground initially because their thrust is vectored downward. The fuel tanks on the wings have two pylons to them. Not sure why. I'm not looking to get too much higher than this, since it's a short flight. The airspeed indicator is a little bit optimistic, and it doesn't seem to have a upper end red line, which is suspicious. I don't need to go fast, so I probably won't.
Assure that the red hose is separated from the blue hose. I don't know whether this has been done already, but if it hasn't, what you have to do is cut the outer beta cloth sheet down the full length of the hoses, and then also cut the rubber ties that secure the two hoses together, and the hoses should come apart and the comm cable should come off. Over. step that I omitted, which you can do now quite conveniently, and it's this. Where you stuff the towel into the bypass hole on the bottom, we recommend that you cut a few short pieces of tape and just tape that over so it doesn't fall out. Over.
Some sight of the ground there. We are currently past Iliamna Lake, which is a fairly big lake on this route. It's back there somewhere. And head towards the Cook Inlet, which leads up to Anchorage. Some nice mountains up ahead. More checklists. There's going to be a lot of checklists. There is the best flare speed thing down there. The weights and the flare speed with full flaps. We're probably gonna be pretty heavy. Expect that I'll be coming in fast. Just fair warning ahead of time. I usually come in fast anyway, so.
Hello, Aquarius, Houston. Jim, that got a little data priority going today, and want to convene the CPCB, and we'll have you all kinds of good procedures for later on. Over.
All kinds of good procedures.
Okay, thanks, Tom. You guys are really working overtime.
How are we getting coordination down here? Pass on to Jim. He had such a long day yesterday, he thought he was going to have to play him some guitar music to get him to sleep last night. Over.
That's exactly what he did.
It's saying encoding overloaded again, so if the video is a little bit choppy, it might be because of the clouds and all.
This is Apollo Control, 91 hours.
We're about halfway through the flight.
In the last hour or so, spacecraft communicator Joe Kerwin has passed up to the crew some items of shade tree engineering. How to build the lithium hydroxide canister container, which uses the suit system or suit circuit.
Oh, there's a glacier there.
And these two canisters will scrub the atmosphere.
Don't know its name though. There's some other glaciers that associated with that mountain, I think, to the right.
To, look forward to the time when the time is run out on the canisters in the lunar module.
Yeah, there's like eight glaciers associated with that mountain. All named different things. Lateral Glacier, Tongue Glacier, Double Glacier, Johnson Glacier. Lots of stuff, but this one down here, I don't have a name for. I don't know what mountain that is. I can only see the glacier names because the glaciers are physically very big while the peak is just a point. Moving maps are complicated.
Still hovering around 12 to 14 amps. At this time, Hayes apparently is still sleeping. All consumable usage is either on or below the predicted levels.
So we can see cooking lit now. That's to the right, the water. I mean, that's obviously photo scenery. But at lower altitudes, it doesn't look quite as good. Up here, it looks okay, except for scenes where there's color correction issues. At lower levels, it's more problematic. Blocky-ish.
IMU, coach.
Yep, lots of terrain seems here. Go with this view.
FDAI select number one. And FDAI source GDC, over.
Every little strip was taken at a different season with different cloud cover. There's a strip here that had a lot of clouds. We don't have anchorage visible yet. Okay. So, not time to descend yet.
Rotation control power normal, 2 to off, and rotation control power direct 2 to off, over. Okay. Okay, the next two are unchanged, and we want the 3 BMAG switches in rate 2, over.
Oh, this is a bad patch of scenery there. That tan area, definitely not right. Okay, we can see Anchorage now. Not that. No, that's okay. Even the VOR is TED, huh? There's also a little seam of weird scenery there.
Talkbacks stand by one and I'll check that.
Okay, I guess we can start descending. I mean, I've already started descending a little bit from the altitude that I mostly cruised at.
In their present position, which is center, but because we have no power on the bus, the bottom row of talkbacks will be spring-loaded to the barber pole position, and that's for your information. Over. Okay, the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the same, and we want EDS auto to off. Over.
Okay.
Okay, the next 3 are the same, and then we want propellant dump to RCS command, 2 engine out to off, and launch vehicle rates to off. Over.
I don't think there are air brakes on this. Nope, I would have activated them. Oh. I think we just heard somebody following on my Twitch channel. That's the follow sound. OBS really shouldn't have been picking up the follow sounds, but I don't know. It's weird sometimes. Got good scenery over on this side, so we'll go with this side.
Okay, Jack. back. Those are the only changes on page 1-3.
Okay, target 2 off. And then I'll just come on down. Roger, warning. Normal, Zach Molly. Roger, warning. CSM. Roger, warning. CSM. CF. Roger, warning. Power off. H2 and O2 heaters off.
That's correct, Jack. Those are the only changes on 1-3. Now let's go to 1-4. No changes on the remaining three panel 2 switches. On panel 3, the first 1, 2, 3, 4 are unchanged. And then we want fuel cell heaters 3 to off. Over.
Okay.
Okay, the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are the same. And then we want fuel cell 1 main bus A to off. And skipping one, we want fuel cell 2 main bus A to off. Over.
Okay.
Okay, skip two, and then we want fuel cell 3 main bus A talkback to gray. Over.
So we're crossing a bay here, and on the other side is Anchorage.
Skip one, and we want fuel cell 1 main bus B talkback to gray. Over.
Okay.
Okay, skip one, and we want fuel cell 2 main bus B talkback gray. And the next one, we want fuel cell 3 main bus B to off. Over. Okay, skip one, and we want main bus B reset to off. Over.
Okay.
All right, then the next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the same. And then we want S-band transponder to center off. Skip one, and we want S-band power amplifier high to center off. And a power amplifier talkback to barber pole. Over.
There's an island there. Can't see the name of it. But it's right off the shore of Anchorage. I basically idled the engines, so, and without air brakes I can't get any slower, so we're having to take a very measured approach here. And we can see Anchorage up ahead, the airport there. Well, next time I'll give the B-1B a try, I think. We'll see.
Okay, Jack, that's completely correct on 1-4. Let's go to 1-5. And on that page, the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the same. And we want up telemetry command to off.
I'm gonna have to circle around a few times just to bleed off speed and altitude.
Okay, the next 1, 2, 3 are the same, and we want VHF AMB to center. Over.
Got it.
The next 1, 2, 3, 4 are the same, and we want S-band squelch to off, and fuel cell reactance valve to normal. Over.
Okay,
the next 1, 2, 3 are the same. The Then we want tape recorder forward to center. Tape motion chalk back barber pole. SCE power to center. And PMP power to center. Over. Okay, skip the next one, and we want AC inverter 1 to off, and AC inverter 2 to off. Over.
A little bit fast, below 10,000 feet here.
Okay, skip the next, and we want inverter 1, AC 1 to off, and skip 2, and we want AC 1
to off. Elmendorf Air Force Base in front of us. Lots of runways around Anchorage.
Bus reset. AC2 bus reset to off.
Okay.
That was AC bus 2.
Maybe I should land at the Air Force Base, but no, I rode in.
We want SPS gauging.
Rode in the airport, so I'll just stick to that.
Telcom Group 2 to off. And glycol pumps.
As appropriate as the Air Force Base may be, given the plane I'm flying and the plane I'm planning to fly next.
Okay, ready, back. Uplifter command, off. VHF-AMP, center. FN-12, off. Fuel cell react valve, normal. Safety quarter forward, center.
Correct on 1-5, Jack. Let's go to 1-6. And the first line, we want suit compressors both to off. Over. Let's go to panel 5. We want fuel cell pumps. AC1 off, AC2 off, and that's the fuel cell 1 pumps, AC1 off, fuel cell 2 pumps, AC2 off, fuel cell 3 pumps, AC2 off, GNN power off, and both the main bus ties off. Over.
Okay.
Okay, skip 2. And then we want interior integral lighting off and interior floodlight off.
But fast.
Scratch out full dim or full bright. Over.
Okay.
Okay, and circuit breakers on panel 5. We want all open. Over.
Well, it has lots of lift. It's got a big wing and everything. A little bit hard to slow down without air brakes.
Okay, on panel 6, skip the first one. We want power to off. And skip down then to suit power to off. Over. on panel 7. We want EDS power off, TBC servo power 1 and 2 off, FDAI GPI power off, and logic 2/3 power off. Over.
Trying to figure out what airport this one is right in front of us. Oh, Merrill Field. This is Merrill Field. Elmendorf is the bigger runway up ahead. There's even some small airstrips over to the right there. Anchorage is mostly airstrips, it seems like. Airfields, airports, and airstrips.
Roger. SPS gauging 4 to open.
Okay, a little bit of flaps. Landing gear down.
Okay, with me, 6R2 at the moment.
Roger. The next is EDS-3 to open.
And into the cockpit now.
Roger. The next are ELS Bat A, Bat B, 2. Open.
That next notch of flaps gave a lot of lift. Well, we don't want to stall or anything.
ELS Bat A and Bat B, 2. Open.
Down, down, down.
Roger. Post landing vent. Flight/post-landing to open. Direct Ullage 2 to open.
SPS Direct Ullage 2 to open.
That's correct. And the next ones are SMRCS heater A main B and heater C main B open.
Okay, please be nice and no, it's not lined up with the runway.
Okay.
That's correct. And SMRCS heater B main A open and heater D main A open. Over.
Oh, there's actually two runways parallel like that. Okay, nope, more speed, please.
Okay, got those two?
Okay, Jack, that's the last of the additions to this page. Go back to the regular checklist and go to the auto RCS select switches.
Ray high here.
16 of them open. Over. That is off.
Okay. Okay, they're setting it off right now. All 16 auto RCS.
At least it's handling, right?
Okay, then we go down to interior numerics lighting off, interior integral lighting off, and interior flood lighting off. Over.
Okay. Yeah, we're very fast.
Skip 3, we want Sex Logic 2 off down and Sex Pyro Arm 2 off down. Over.
Okay.
Okay, and on panel 9, power to off. Over.
Okay, we're down. It's a interesting landing gear configuration as well, right? It's got the back landing gear and the front landing gear and the wingtip landing gears as well.
Circuit breakers, because we copied them as you went. If you just want to read back
inline
the
gear.
Panel 9 changes.
All right, let's
go. Could have probably made this turn boggle for the next one. Alright, we have landed at Anchorage safely and not in an embarrassing manner this time. So yeah, experimental flight model, I think it's still very experimental. I'm not fond of it, I'll tell you that right now. But I mean, I guess that's because different planes aren't made for it, but then how many of the planes that we have will really be properly updated for it, I don't know. So, I don't want to lose the ability to fly some of these things. Okay, I think I'll pause the Apollo 13 audio right there. They seem to be in a lull. They're going through all their procedures. The Apollo 13 movie sure didn't, I don't know, I it's been a long time since I saw it, but I'm guessing that it wasn't 2 hours of reading up procedures, so it wasn't realistic. But, yeah, next time, either the B-1B or the B-52 is what I'm looking at, and we're going for Juno. Of course, nice big runway, hopefully, at Juno. Hopefully. And as I turn off the runways and slow down here, I'll say thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this flight. If you did, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.